This is the story of the act which gained for Naik Nand Singh of the 1st 11th Sikh Regiment a very well-earned Victoria Cross. His regiment had, in a most successful attack, secured the heights on both sides of the road from Mongdor to Butidong. This defile was the gateway to Butidong and was the last good position available to the Japs guarding the town. That night, the Japs managed to infiltrate round the flank of the battalion position and dig themselves in on a spur commanding the road. This spur was only 100 foot or so high, but like so many hills in the Arakan, was an absolute knife edge, with precipitous slopes covered with thick, impassable bamboo jungle. There was only one way up, along the narrow path which led to the top. Single file was the only possible formation for the attack. As dawn broke, and the Jap position was spotted from the battalion headquarters, urgent action had to be taken. The spur had to be cleared before a tank column, accompanied by a Gurkha battalion, could pass through into Butidong. The column was due in about an hour's time. The company, in which Nand Singh was a section commander, was given the task. Nand Singh's section was to lead the attack, and his objective was three enemy trenches at the top of the spur. Once these were captured, the rest of the company could get a footing and be enabled to get on with some fire support. But to get these first positions, no fire support was possible. Determination, dash, and high courage on the part of the leading section were the only means of getting there. With a tremendous shout of Sat Sri Akal, the famous Sikh battle cry, Nand Singh led the attack. As the enemy positions were approached, the narrow track was swept by automatic fire and bombarded with hand grenades. Every man in his section was knocked out, but by some miracle, he himself alone was seen to reach the first trench, though apparently hit. He disappeared from view, but emerged after a time and crawled towards the next trench, from which a shower of grenades landed all round him, one bursting within a few feet of his head. He crawled on, hurled his own grenades, and entered the enemy trench. Again he disappeared from view, but soon staggered out, and went straight at the next trench, into which he jumped. And at last his head appeared, and victoriously announced that the position was captured, and the enemy garrison killed. His company followed up without delay, and with this foothold on the top in our hands, was able to clear the remaining positions. 37 Japs were killed, only three managed to make their escape. Nand Singh had been hit by a bullet in the thigh before reaching the first trench, and also had a large number of fragments of grenade all over his body. But he's a tough, hardy peasant of the Punjab, with 10 years army service, and was back again at duty in his battalion within 6 weeks. Such is the stuff of which our Indian battalions are made. We, who belong to the Indian Army, are proud to have the honour of leading such men in battle.